Good morning, I'm Dr. Huang. Today, I'm going to teach you a systematic method to write down the Lewis structures with resonance structures and formal charges. There are a lot of molecules and ions whose Lewis structures are very difficult to write down correctly. Here is a list of them. Well, if you can follow the procedures I'm teaching you here, it will be relatively easy and relatively fast to write down the correct Lewis structures with resonance structures and formal charges for any molecule or any ion. The first step of this method is to obtain a skeleton structure from an instructor. In a skeleton structure, a line or sometimes a dotted line tells us that there is a chemical bond between the two atoms. However, I want to emphasize, a line or sometimes a dotted line in a skeleton structure is not always a single bond in the Lewis structure. It can also be a double bond or a triple bond. In a skeleton structure, if there's no line between two atoms, that means there's no chemical bond between them. The second step of this method is to place the valence electrons next to each atom. Each iodine atom has 7 valence electrons. Each fluorine atom also has 7 valence electrons. You can find the number of valence electrons of any atom from a periodic table. This ion has +1 charge. Therefore, we should lose 1 valence electron from what we have already. In general, when you take away an electron, you take away from the least electronegative atom of the molecule or ion. In this case, we know that iodine has smaller electronegativity than fluorine. Therefore, we will take away 1 electron from the iodine atom. You can also wait until we finish the first step to take away electrons. But to avoid forgetting to take away the electron, I just take away the electron right now. Now let me show you how I place the valence electrons next to each atom. You can start from any atom. Let's start from the central atom. From the skeleton structure, the central atom has 4 neighbors. Remember, we need 1 valence electron from the central atom for each neighbor. We will take the first valence electron of the central iodine atom and we place it between the central atom and its neighbor on the left. We will take the second valence electron of the central iodine atom and we place it between the central atom and its neighbor at the bottom. We will take the third valence electron of the central iodine atom and replace it between the central iodine atom and the fluorine atom on the right. We will take the fourth valence electron of the central iodine atom and replace it between the central atom and its neighbor on top. Well, after this step, we have 2 valence electrons left for the central iodine atom. In general, we will place the valence electrons left from the previous step into groups of 2 electrons, unless we have odd number electrons. Since we have 2 valence electrons left from the previous step, we will place them into 1 group. Well, you may wonder, Dr. H, where do we place this group of electrons? As long as you don't place them between the central atom and any of its neighbors, it should be fine. Let's place them here. Well, we can do the same for the other 4 atoms. Let's place the valence electrons of the fluorine atom on the left first. From the skeleton structure, the fluorine atom on the left has only 1 neighbor, which is the central iodine atom. Therefore, we will take 1 of the valence electrons of the fluorine atom on the left and we place it between the fluorine atom on the left and its only neighbor. Then we will place the 6 valence electrons left from the previous step into 3 groups. Remember, when we place the valence electrons left from the previous step into groups, we prefer to have groups of 2 electrons, unless we have odd number of valence electrons left from the previous step. If we have odd number of electrons left from the previous step, we will have 1 group with only 1 electron. All the other groups should have 2 electrons. But 6 is an even number, therefore, we will have 3 groups of 2 electrons. We will do the same for the other 3 fluorine atoms. Well, the next step, we are going to replace the 2 electrons between the 2 atoms with a single stick, which means a single bond in the Lewis structure. Well, the next step is to make sure every atom will have either an octet or extended octet. Now let me explain what is an octet. An octet means an atom must have 8 octet electrons. Octet electrons are the electrons we placed next to that atom. They include lone pair electrons and shared pair electrons. Lone pair electrons are not shared between atoms. Therefore, they are only being counted as octet electrons once. Shared pair electrons are shared between two atoms. Therefore, they are counted as octet electrons for both atoms. They are being counted as octet electrons twice. Well, let's count how many octet electrons for each atom. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Let's count the total number of octet electrons of the central atom. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Well, remember, the valence shell of the iodine is N equal to 5. Therefore, it can have more than 8 electrons, which we call an extended octet. Well, from the structure we just get, it seems every atom either have an octet or extended octet. Therefore, this should be a good Lewis structure. But remember, do not forget to calculate the formal charges of all atoms. After our calculation, we find that only the central atom has plus 1 formal charge. All the other atoms have 0 formal charge. Therefore, we need to place plus 1 formal charge next to the central atom. Well, from the Lewis structure we just got, it has 4 single bonds. It does not have any double bond or triple bond. Therefore, this ion should only have 1 Lewis structure. It does not have resonance structures. This should be the Lewis structure you need to present to me during exam or quiz for this ion. A good Lewis structure should only include atomic symbols, lines, dots, and all non-zero formal charges.